Since the success of the 2002 film Panic Room, the wealthy around the world were inspired to create their own safe rooms and bunkers. These types of security rooms offer peace of mind to those that build them secretly in their property. With the concerning events around the world at the moment, the creators of panic rooms have seen a sharp increase in demand. Today we're going to look at some of the celebrities and wealthy that have their own safe room or bunker, as well as any other security features that their property may boast. So let's get started. In 2014, multi-award-winning musician and actor Lady Gaga splashed out on a new home in Malibu, all for the tidy sum of $23 million. The South of France-inspired property has loads of extras that most houses will not have, one of which is the safe-slash-panic room. The entrance into the safe haven is hidden within the master bedroom's closet, specifically the his closet instead of the hers. That way, if an intruder did break in, they'd struggle to find where Gaga and company went. Sadly, like a lot of these celebs, we don't get to see the inside of Gaga's panic room due to safety. After all, showing the world a panic room would allow intruders to prepare for this possibility. That wouldn't be too safe. It wasn't Gaga that installed this extra security measure in the mansion. It was the house's previous owner, Dan Romanelli. He founded and was president of Warner Brothers Worldwide Consumer Products. Due to this, he regularly dealt with a lot of Batman merchandise. Romanelli took this interest and incorporated it into his home by creating a kind of bat cave, along with a safe room. There's a secret entrance to the bat cave in the living room. Inside the cave, there are such features as an 800-bottle wine cellar, a home theater, a 1960s-themed two-lane bowling alley, and much more. David Beckham is a football/soccer legend. Victoria Beckham is a fashion and music icon with the Spice Girls. The married couple currently have 4 children. With that narrative, it's only fair that the security will be a big factor in their home. In 2013, after David had retired from his sport, the Beckhams permanently relocated back to London from Los Angeles. They found their dream 7-bedroom, 5-story mansion near Kensington Palace. Their new home cost the couple a nifty $62 million. However, there were some missing touches the Beckhams wanted for their new home, so they renovated it. The house now offers extras like a library, an underground car park for David's collection, and an indoor movie theater, along with other specialties. After living in LA, the Beckhams picked up on an important aspect of their American counterparts, security. They had 60 CCTV cameras and a soundproof panic room installed. The family felt that the mansion's current safety measures weren't enough. The panic room is also reinforced to hinder any intruders looking to break in. There's also said to be a tunnel under the house for a security team to take the family to a separate location, if need be. The extra security features are estimated to have cost the Beckhams $1.2 million. Shortly after George Clooney and Amal Alamuddin got married in 2014, they decided to renovate their 17th-century home in Berkshire, England. The $12 million house is already in a pretty secluded area for privacy and security's sake, but they felt that their house needed more of a guarantee, so they installed a panic room. It's said to be fireproof, bombproof, and attack-resistant. They've also got 18 CCTV cameras installed on 16-foot-long poles all over the property, which apparently upset a lot of their neighbors in the area. It's easy to think that this security concern is due to Clooney's high-profile acting job, yet it's actually all for Alamuddin. She works as a human rights lawyer and has been involved in a number of controversial cases over the years. Due to her marriage to Clooney, her profile has risen even more. As such, the safe room will also act as a sort of file cabinet. Like any lawyer, she'll have papers containing the personal information of her clients. Some of the people she's faced off against in court may be interested in getting their hands on those details. So, Alamuddin stores the papers within the heavily reinforced panic room, keeping both her and Clooney, as well as the private information, safe. Holly Vance is an actor and musician that's best known for her role in the Australian soap opera Neighbours. She's married to property tycoon Nick Candy. He and his brother Christian are one of the wealthiest property developers in the world. One of their projects is called One Hyde Park. One Hyde Park is a luxury apartment building in London. For a time, Vance and Candy lived at the exclusive residential building. It has attracted a lot of wealthy clients since its creation. By 2014, the building had made over $3 billion in sales. Just one of the penthouses went for almost $300 million. All of the penthouses come available with bulletproof glass installed in the windows. Each one also has a secret panic room installed. For security reasons, little is known about what the panic rooms contain. But with so many wealthy clients living within the building, we can only assume that the panic rooms are the best money can buy. Write what you think is inside the rooms in the comments below. To up the security further, there's also an iris recognition system within the elevators. There's also bowler hat wearing, SAS-trained security team on hand at all times. In case anything happens, there's also a tunnel under the building that leads into a 5-star hotel nearby. United States Senator Mitt Romney decided to build a new vacation home in 2013. He found the perfect location in Holiday, Utah. For nearly $9 million, he submitted plans to destroy the house already there and construct his own. After his application was successful, the architectural designs were discovered by the newspaper, the Salt Lake Tribune. The biggest takeaway from the plans is the hidden door in a study. It's concealed behind a bookshelf that swivels outward and leads into a room marked as office storage on the plans. Very much like the designs we're showing you now. The room is 11 feet in length and has cabinets lining the walls, which suits the office storage narrative the plans pushed. Yet when Romney and his representatives have been asked by the media about the concealed door, they have declined to comment, which is a little suspicious, leading many to believe that after the Romneys had to give up their Secret Service protection in 2012, they built a safe room in response for protection. Romney's son, Craig Romney, may have a similar architectural taste as his father. In his home, he has turned one of his main staircases into a slide. There's also a whimsical swing in the middle of the living room. The former U.S. Senator Bob Kerry was president of the New School from 2001 to 2010. During that time, the New York-based university set up Kerry in a $20,000 a month townhouse. The four-bedroom house was an ideal place for Kerry. It had plenty of space for entertaining and a rooftop terrace. Yet in the master bedroom, Kerry discovered a hidden safe room concealed within a closet. The room inside is 8 by 12 feet. The whole room is said to be bulletproof as well. It wasn't the current owners that installed the panic room in the property, but the previous owner, Gwyneth Paltrow. Before she started selling weirdly scented candles, Paltrow purchased the Manhattan property in 1988. As her profile rose, Paltrow invested in a panic room to keep herself safe from intruders. However, she would then have children. The panic room no longer felt like enough. She wanted added protection for her family, such as a doorman on the property. Eventually, she sold the townhouse in 2005 for an estimated $7 million. A spokesperson for Paltrow later claimed that the room, quote, wasn't a safe room. She stored clothes in it. Considering neither Kerry nor the current owners knew about the hidden room, this is unlikely to be the case. In 2018, Facebook spent a massive $22.6 million on keeping founder Mark Zuckerberg and his family safe. The family are said to have armed guards constantly watching over them. Zuckerberg is so careful with security that he purchased all the other homes around his in Palo Alto, California, for extra protection and privacy. He spent somewhere between $30 to $44 million on tearing down the houses. Later, he planned to replace them with smaller buildings. Already, Zuckerberg is said to have a panic room installed in all the houses he uses. Yet in Palo Alto, plans were discovered that suggested he could be creating a panic house. The plans say that one of the houses will have, quote, white brick walls, dark steel doors and windows, dark gray siding, and louvers where they occur above the roof line, and a dark gray standing seam metal roof, end quote. This building has been described as a bunker that could potentially keep him safe for months. For extra security, Zuckerberg apparently has a secret escape passage in his office's conference room. If need be, he and the other employees could use this escape chute to be evacuated from the building as quickly as possible. Olena Pinchuk is best known for her charity work with founding the Anti-AIDS Foundation. As a result, she became good friends with music icon Sir Elton John. She's also the daughter of former Ukraine President Leonid Kuchma. In 2008, Pinchuk spent $127 million on a building that used to be a girls' preparatory school in Kensington, England. Soon after purchasing number 17 Upper Fillmore Gardens, the house was massively renovated for almost 2 years. An underground swimming pool, a gym, sauna, and cinema were all added to the 10-bedroom building. But the key element was the panic room. Little is known about the panic room, sadly. With Pinchuk's connection to the Ukrainian government, she has had to take extra measures to make sure she's safe wherever she lives. The five-story house was valued at $1.58 billion in 2014. As a result, Pinchuk's panic room is likely to be one of the most luxurious examples in the world, such as this high-end cocktail bar-themed safe room. A lot of the super rich are spending $500,000 on extravagant panic rooms, containing bars, TVs, and other luxurious items to help them cope while they're stuck within their safe rooms. In 2010, Kevin Smith finally let the cat out of the bag in an interview. In 2001, he was at Ben Affleck's house for a barbecue. Affleck wanted to show Smith something in his bedroom. They walked into the bedroom and into an office next to it. Inside, there was a bookcase that covered one side of the room. Affleck walks over to the bookcase and presses a button hidden underneath. The bookcase then pushes backwards to reveal a panic room. Smith describes the entrance as something the Batcave would have. Affleck was showing off his love of Batman way before he donned the cloak and cowl. But the panic room itself wasn't very Batman. It was small. Smith states it's around 2 feet by 2 feet in size. He thinks it might have been a small bathroom before being converted into a panic room. Inside the room was a safe to store valuables, a video monitor linked up to cameras around the house, and a telephone. Affleck apparently spent $50,000 on creating this hidden room. In 2003, Smith actually purchased the house from Affleck. However, he doesn't use the safe room for its intended use. As Smith states, he's not Affleck, and no one will steal him. So, the panic room is used to store old toys belonging to his kids. The actor and TV host Melissa Rivers put her Pacific Palisades, California home on the market in 2018. Originally, she wanted a little over $6 million. She first bought the property in 1998 for $2.35 million. Since then, she's added some extra features to improve her home over the years. Once she put it up for sale, one of the key selling points was mentioned. Rivers has a walk-in closet that doubles as a safe room within her master bedroom. Even with the added security, the house had to be sold for almost $1 million less money in 2019. Melissa probably gets the appreciation of panic rooms from her late mother, comedian Joan Rivers. Joan had a panic room installed in her Fifth Avenue penthouse as protection from stalkers. In an interview in 2005 with The Independent, Joan mentioned that she had stalkers that would call her and leave messages on her answer phone. She then quickly changed the subject with the interviewer. In 2015, Joan's penthouse was sold for $28 million. The new owner then gutted the home and stripped it back. As such, the panic room was likely sadly torn down as a result. What would your ideal panic room look like? Would it be like the Batcave or something out of Mad Men? Pop your thoughts in the comments below. If you felt somewhat enlightened by this video, please like it, share it on social media, and subscribe to us to stay up to date. All of those actions really help us out in the ever-changing YouTube landscape. Finally, thanks for joining us today. We'll see you next time.